Greetings of Raksha Bandhan on Nari Purnima. Hope you all are safe, happy and sound at home, enjoying and relaxing the day with your sibling. This is the same day when I uploaded my first video on YouTube last year. It was Ganesh Chaturthi on that day. I later uploaded many more videos related to fashion and reuse ideas. I hope you have watched them. In case if not, please do check them out. Also, a thanks to all those who supported me, watched me and liked my videos. And a big sorry as I was not able to upload in between for certain weeks as I was going through a very bad time. Hope you understand that. Today's video is going to be a designing and stitching of a dress which I had in my mind. To all those who don't know me and are watching for the first time, I'm not a fashion designer and have done just a basic stitching tailoring course. So I actually don't have an idea of how designing and stitching and construction of a garment works. Also, as this is my first experiment and experience of this kind, so I'm not very sure of how it turned out to be. Do comment below if you did like this video so that I can bring such more. Now, as you have seen the sketch drawn and colored, yes, I'm using a blue cloth for this, for stitching this. Now, the occasion which I'll be styling is my birthday on Raksha Bandhan Day, 22nd August. The first cloth is a base cloth of cotton material, which is 2 meters. The next cloth is a polyester cloth, which is mixed cotton mixed polyester, and 1 meter 30 centimeter. The third cloth is a bigger cloth than the first one and is the same one, cotton cloth. I'll be using all these three clothes or pieces to stitch this outfit. The first piece is, as it is 2 meter, I'll be using it for the down bottom. I have one for the front side. I'll be cutting it into half, one for the front side and then other for the back side. For this, I'll be attaching canvas at the bottom. This is not a soft canvas. It is a hard one which has a sticky glue, as you will be seeing me ironing it at the end of the video. For attaching it at the bottom or the base, I'm giving it a pleat by giving a bigger stitches from the machine. 2 stitches, one below the other for the complete straight round. And then I've divided it into two parts, each one I'm giving two stitches, then pulling it, pleating it and arranging it for with the topmost portion. For the top cutting, I have used the bigger third piece of cloth, which is bigger in size, and then I have given a marking and then cut it as per my size. Top or the blouse more portion will come just below my bust level, and it portion will start below the bust till the below ankle level. As the second piece, polyester mix cloth, is not in level, I'll be leveling the cloth and then using it. This piece I'll be using on the neck to give a pattern, and then on below my bust area for the cut or the pattern which I'm doing. The polyester will come only on the topmost portion, whereas the cotton cloth will go below so that it will be comfortable for wearing in humid climate and even in summer season. Sleeves will be a bit longer than the 3/4, but not complete to the full length, as I want to pair it with some watch, some bracelet, which should be visible, so I have kept it in that manner. I'll be using the same polyester cloth on the neck too, giving a V detailing, for which I've cut first the cotton cloth in V neck, then I'll be cutting the polyester cloth and the canvas cloth lesser than the polyester cloth so that I can fold the cloth and stitch it. Before stitching, I'll be just ironing it to make sure it gets ticked up with the glue, and then I'll be folding first on the wrong side, then I'll be bringing it in the front, double folding it and stitching it. First, I'll be stitching only the neck portion, and then below it, I'll be attaching double folded cloth by pleating pattern like a ruffle on the neck details so that it looks good, and stitch it. Below that, I'll be using a square patch again in the same manner by polyester cloth a little less, 1 centimeter on all four sides, a hard canvas, ironing it and then folding it and stitching it, giving a good finish to the neck. For the sleeve marking, I have first kept a cut dress portion or the top blouse portion and then marked it. I then cross-checked it with my other stitched dress, which I wore in a Raksha Bandhan outfit A-line white kurta that I'm using for measurement and then marked it and then cut it. This I'm keeping long and further I'm attaching a cuff-like portion for which I'll be using two pieces of cloth. For how much measurement I want, I'll be keeping 2 cm extra, and the measurement which I want, that much I'm taking canvas in the length and width, how much my wide my hands are, and then I'm stitching it, attaching both the light blue and the dark blue, that is the cotton and the polyester, and ironing the with the glue on the cotton cloth. I stitched this and attached it. Once I attached the sleeve to the top portion, after attaching the shoulders, you can stitch it before or after as per you wish to. Now I'm using cotton cloth as it is good for summers or any humid weather. You can use any other fabric also and try the same way in case if you did like it. At the end, it shouldn't be itchy, so I'm folding these two pieces of cloth inside inward and then stitching it and giving it a finish like a shirt front cuff portion, like the pattern it has in full sleeve shirt. Now for the attaching of the slit portion, I just measured the portion below my knee length, how much it comes right from the below bust portion. Then I used the same measurement plus 1 cm for the margin and then just cut it off from the polyester cloth. Then I used it, stitched the three sides, that is the two sides of it where the slits were to be, and then the bottommost portion. I gave a slightly rounded, it can had been the straight slit too. Next, then I just cut it off from the sides where the slits had to be joined, as I felt the entire cloth couldn't have been stitched in this pattern. For the front cloth where the lower bust cotton lining has to come, or the cotton cloth has to come, there I'll be attaching the slit portions by marking the middle portion, as you will see in almost in the end. And in the same manner, I did this plain cloth at the back. For both back as well as the front two slit cloths, I've given a slight pleating even on the polyester cloth too, so that a finishing or the fall of the cloth will come well. This I did to make it look good. Also, there was another reason that the cotton cloth was slightly transparent, not much, making it visible in the line. So I attached this to make it look good. Also making it appropriate to wear it at any part or point of the day. Here I would make another note that I had in my mind to decorate it even more by adding cloth flowers, as you can see in the starting designing part, which I didn't find time and was not able to complete it. Hope you understand, as I am not going out anywhere, so I am okay with whatever I have done. I stitched it, I did and saw it fits well and is comfortable for me. Hope you did like it. And if you did like it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to watch me the next time I upload a video. Also, this initially I used to upload twice a week. These days I'm uploading only once a week. Once again, thanks to all those who have subscribed to my channel. I truly value you.